Hello students, now we discuss about the agro complementary occupations. What is meant by agro complementary occupations? The occupation carried by the farmers along with farming is called as agro complementary occupations, and this occupation increase the income of the farmer, and these occupations are related to the agriculture. So first is the animal husbandry. Animal husbandry is an agro-complementary occupation. It is practiced for milk production and for using the cattle for farming operations. In animal husbandry, the number of cattle, their variety, total milk production, cleanliness in cattle shed, arrangements for health care of cattle are taken into consideration. Cows and buffaloes, rates for milk production, beef-stock burdens such as bulls and male buffaloes. Some local Indian varieties of cows are Sahiwal, Sindhi, Gir, Lal Kandhari, Devani, Devani, Killari and Dangi. And some exotic varieties of cows are also used for milk production like Jersey, Brown Swiss and Holstein. For a clean and high yield of milk, care of cattle is necessary. A balanced diet consisting of all nutrients, fiber-rich, coarse food, fodder, and sufficient water should be fed to the cattle. The cattle shed should be clean and dry with proper ventilation and a roof. Cattle should be regularly and periodically vaccinated. Second agro-complementary occupation is the poultry farming. Poultry farming kya hai? It is a rearing of chicken with all the care and techniques to obtain egg and meat. Objective of hybridization of Indian SL and exotic Leghorn varieties of chicken are to produce good quality chicken in a large number, to develop the ability to withstand high temperature, and third, to use byproduct of agriculture as a poultry feed. Chicken reared for both eggs and meat are Rhode Island Red, New Hampshire, Plymouth Rock and Black Rock. Layers are egg laying varieties like Leghorn, Minorca, Ancona and Lehman. Broilers are meat giving varieties like Brahma, Long, Cochin and SL. Then next is the sericulture. Sericulture is the agro complementary occupation for the production of silk through silkworm. Bombex mora is the most commonly used variety for obtaining silk through sericulture practice. In the life history of silk moth Bombex mori, there are four stages: egg, larva, pupa and adult. So egg laid by female moth are incubated artificially to shorten the incubation period. And incubation period short karne ke liye jo eggs rehte hai usko kya kiya jata hai, artificially incubate kiya jata hai. देन एक में से जो लार्वी बाहर आते हैं तो उनको क्या किया जाता है, लार्वी आर नरिश बाय फीडिंग ऑन मलबरी लीव्स. आफ्टर फीडिंग फॉर 3 to 4 डेज लार्वी मूव टू द ब्रांचेस ऑफ मलबरी प्लांट. द सिल्क थ्रेड इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम द सिक्रीशन ऑफ देयर सलाइवरी ग्लैंड सो दैट लार्वी सिक्रीट्स सम सिक्रीशन थ्रू द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड एंड इन दिस वे दे फॉर्म द ककून अराउंड इटसेल्फ. So in the larval stage, the larva weaves the silk thread around the body and forms the cocoon. This spherical cocoon is taken care of. Now before the pupa turns into an adult, yani pupa ka conversion adult stage mein hone ke pehle kya kiya jata hai? Ye jo cocoon hai usko garam pani mein kya kiya jata hai? Dala jata hai to kill the silkworm within. The boiling water also makes the silk fiber loose. Aur dusra ek boiling water ka ek kya fayda hai? कि उससे जो सिल्क फाइबर है वो क्या होता है, लूज होता है और वो निकालने के लिए आसानी होती है. दिस फाइबर्स आर देन अनवाउंड प्रोसेस एंड रीड. उसके बाद में ये जो फाइबर्स है वो क्या किए जाते हैं, अनवाउंड किए जाते हैं, उसके ऊपर प्रोसेसिंग किया जाता है एंड देन रील किए जाते हैं. वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ फैब्रिक्स आर वोवन फ्रॉम द प्रोसेस सिल्क थ्रेड. नाउ सी हियर द वेरियस स्टेजेस ऑफ silk moth. First is the eggs. This is the eggs stage. Then from egg there is a larva is produced. देन लार्वा इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू द प्यूपा स्टेज एंड प्यूपा इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू द अडल्ट मॉथ एंड दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ककून्स.